continue na. Now, how do we know, diba, when we say star? So, as I said, a star is made of gases. So, almost 71% hydrogen, 27% helium, and 2% maybe a combination of different heavier elements. So, kahapon, we are just discussing only that a star, nabubuo siya from stellar nebula, pero made of gases talaga siya. So, merong tanong dito, if galaxies are moving towards us or away from us, do you think? Ano kaya? Yung mga galaxies, since galaxy is away. A cluster of stars. So, away? Bakit? What are your bases? Sino yung sumagot? Si Daniel? David? Bakit mo nasabi? Bakit mo nasabi that galaxies...
Since merong nag-theorize na... since may nag-theorize na the universe is expanding, so we could actually hypothesize na, oh, since nag-expand siya, lalong lumalaki-laki yung space in between those galaxies, syempre, sabihin, lumalayo nang lumalayo instead of being it closer. Until one day, na nag-shift ulit, na imbis na mag-away, inabsorb ulit ng universe yung sarili niya and cause another big bang explosion and birth of another universe ulit.
Okay, so, pero you know what, in conclusion, tingnan nyo yung nakalagay sa pinakailalim. Can you read it, Mr. or Miss Maricar? Ano daw nakasabi dyan? Ano ang sabi dyan? Nababasa nyo ba PowerPoint? Yes?
If we've never been there?
Yes, so... Nobody can answer pa. We are just relying on the theory, sabi nga ni Javed. But still, we've never been there. So we cannot assume na is it moving towards us or away from us. Okay. Also, we are going to discuss more on light because since a star is made of gases and that gases gives the fuel for a star, so a light is a form of electromagnetic radiation, which is energy that travels in waves. Alam nyo na yan in your physics. So, with that waves, no, it is composed of electromagnetic radiation and is arranged in a continuum called the electromagnetic spectrum. So, kung titingnan natin yung mga waves na yon, they are made of electromagnetic spectrum. So, ito yung mga mukha niya. Kung na-lesson nyo yan in your high school physics, no? A waves is composed of merong, yes, long wavelength, merong pa short wavelength. Okay. Sige. So, with that, all are visible colors doon sa wavelengths. And the emission spectrum is lines of specific colors. So, there also an absorption of spectrum, meaning all visible colors with specific wavelengths remove forming dark lines. So, from here, ayan, kung titingnan natin, for example, this yellow represents incandescent solid, liquid, or compressed gas. So, kung titingnan natin yung waves niya sa loob, parang ito siya, oh, a continuous spectrum. And also, since it is made of gas cloud, oh, ayan. So, parang there is an emission of spectrum and absorption of spectrum. So, kung nakikita nyo, merong mga dark lines which are, as I said, those are removing or forming dark lines. Okay. May nagtatanong dito anong code. Sino yung nag-chat sa GC? Ba't hindi pa siya makapasok? Di ba diretso mo lang na-click?
Si Sherwin, sir.
Oo, sige. I-send ko muna yung code. Wait. O, ayun na. May nag-reply na. May nag-reply na. Okay. Sige. Ayan. So, let's continue. Nakapasok na kaya siya? Andito na ba siya? So, with that presentation, the absorption or the emission and absorption spectra are characteristics of the chemical composition of the gas cloud. So we can say that kung titingnan natin yung mga gas cloud na yon, yun ang kanyang chemical composition. Yun ang parang nasa loob niya talaga, no? Both emission and absorption spectrum. Okay. Now, so what are the examples of spectra? So, based in our periodic table of elements, so nandun ang mga examples of spectra. Also, incorporated din dito ang Big Bang Theory. It's because, according to this theory, no, almost 15 billion years ago, the universe started with a compressed or into infinitely small space or what we call the primordial atom. So, ilang years exploded with a sudden burst of energy. So, imagine nyo, yun ang ginaturo ng Big Bang Theory. So, after the explosion, it created small, super dense, ano pa, extremely hot universe. Okay. With that, expanded also in all directions, kasi nga mainit pa siya. So, as things cooled, matter clumped, forming stars and galaxies. So, imagine nyo ha, from explosion, nagkatag sila because of coldness, so dumaan at na-form ang mga stars. So, 100 million years after Big Bang, stars started to form. So, imagine, parang matagal pa, from 15 billion years ago, after the explosion, almost 100 million years pa nabuo ang mga stars. And that is according to Big Bang Theory, a Big Bang stars started to form. So, parang ganito, almost 13.7 billion, hanggang ayan, nagkaroon ng inflation, 380,000, tiny fraction, at nabuo ang mga stars. So, what are the support or evidences that support this theory? Bakit siya parang acceptable theory? It's because there are some remnants of initial heat or tinatawag natin mga cosmic microwave background radiation discovered in 1965 that filled the entire universe. Up to this day, meron talaga mga radiation, no? Microwave radiation. So meaning, there is a great possibility na meron talagang explosion na nangyari. And aside from that, there is an abundance of hydrogen and helium. Hindi tayo na uubusan ng mga hydrogen and helium in the atmosphere, diba? Doon sa outer space, maraming gases. So, the size also of galaxies relative to their position. So, imagine. So, parang katanggap-tanggap talaga ang theory na ito. Another evidence is from Doppler effect. Oh, diba? Ano ba ang Doppler effect? Sige daw. Who can define? What is a Doppler effect? In your physics or chemistry? Anybody? Ang maka-research dyan in Google?
Ako, sir.
Yes, Mr. David. The best in recitation. What is a Doppler effect?
According to Google, the Doppler effect or Doppler shift is the change in frequency of a wave in relation to an observer who is moving relative to a wave source. It is named after the Austrian physicist Christian Doppler, who described the phenomenon in 1842.
Please explain. So meaning, a Doppler effect is from... Halimbawa, kung ikaw yung nag-observe, no, there is an effect from different radiation. So, halimbawa, example, if our star is, meron ganito, oh, mukha niya parang stationary, so yung effect niya on Earth, we see, there is just a regular spectrum, yung mga nakikita natin. Pero kung if a star is advancing, oh, may nakikita tayong mga blue shift. And kung receding star naman siya, red shift ang nakikita natin. So imagine, until now, meron tayong mga blue shift na tinatawag red shift. So also, parang kapanipaniwala din siya na merong mga effect talaga on the outer space and believe on the theory of Big Bang. So according to Edwin Hubble, or Hubble's law said, show that there is a redshift of star spectrums, which shows that galaxies are moving away from us. So, tama din. Galing-galing talaga ni David. No? Sabi ko kanina, just give an educational guess if the galaxy is moving towards us or away from us. So, sabi kanina ni David, moving away. So, very good. Kasi merong supported law from Hubble that because of redshift of star spectrum, na nagpapakita doon that our galaxy are moving away from us. Oh, grabe. Okay, bow na talaga ako kay Daniel. Parang favorite niya talaga ang science. Now, so what's the relevance of light and the universe? So, a light year is actually used as a measurement of the great distances in spaces or in space. Diba yan man talaga mag-measure tayo yung kanilang mga great distance? Tama ba? Light year ang ginagamit natin. So, a light year is the distance that a ray of light can travel in a year. So, imagine. So, yun ang ating measurement. A light year is, how will you measure this one? How many miles? Who can read? A light year is blank miles. Sige nga. Kung magaling dito sa math, how will you describe that? How many miles?
5 trillion. 1 trillion yan siya, sir?
Yes. Continue.
5 trillion.
Ah, si David muna, tapos si Nish. 5 trillion. Go.
Ako na, sir?
Go.
5,865,696,000 miles.
Okay. So, tama ba siya, Nish?
Hindi ko alam.
Tama si David?
Opo.
Okay, so 5...
Kala ko mali.
5,865,696,000,000 miles or in kilometers. Okay, Nish, it's your turn to read in kilometers the light year.
800 million kilometers.
So, masyadong mabilis, no? So, a star or masyadong malayo. A star or a star system's distance from Earth is measured actually in light years. So, when we are measuring the distance of a star from the Earth, so we will use light years. Okay. So, for example, we have here a distances by triangulation. So, we can measure distances by comparing the position of objects observed from two ends of the baseline of a triangle. So, ganun ang pag-measure ng mga distances in triangulation. Kasi ganyan man din tayo mag-measure from here on Earth up to the stars. So, ayan. So, also, we have here the term parallax. When we say a parallax, also, it is a change and an object's direction due to a change in the observer's position. So, for example, if the observer is changing its direction or the object, so parallax ang tawag natin doon. So, astronomers also use, ano yan? Parang may nag-comment ito, ano daw, putol-putol? May nang signal ko? O kayo? Okay lang.
Okay lang, sir.
Okay. Sige, akala ko putol-putol ako. So, please take note that astronomers also use parallax to calculate the distance to the stars. So, they are using the word parsec or short for parallax. Parallax second is a special unit of distance for a star's distance from Earth. So, kung ganito, so kung kanina we are using light years, pwede din itong 1 parsec. So, please take note kasi alangan mag grabe yung computation natin per miles or kilometers, diba? So we will be using 1 parsec equivalent to 3.258 light years. Okay? Ayan. So a parallax also, we can use some of its activity. So for example, let's imagine, hold your thumb. Can you open your camera para I can see you? Sige, let's perform nga this one. Paki-open ang inyong mga camera so that I can see you while you are performing. Sige daw. Hello, are you still there? Hindi ko, i-stop ko muna ang sharing ko. Okay, sige. Dahil naka-open na lahat, sige. Okay, so let's try. Hold your thumb. I hold your thumb up. Where is your thumb up? Can I see your thumb up? Okay. Hold your thumb up steadily in front of you. Sige nga. Oh, nakikita ko dito Enzo, Maricar, Nish. Okay. Hold your thumb up steadily in front of you. Ayan, sarapan ninyo. And then, move your head from side to side and note that the shift of your thumb with respect to background object. So that's what we call the angular shift or called as the parallax. Okay? So move your head side to side. Nag-move na ba? Okay, good. Now, look at your thumb while keeping your head steady, but first, closing one eye, then the other. Sige nga, i-perform natin. Okay. Very good. Sumusunod yung iba. Now, move your thumb closer to you. Does it shift more or less with respect to the background? Bes, sige nga. Let me see kung nakuha ninyo. May mga, what is your observation?
Gabler ang thumb, sir.
Okay, gablered ang thumb. From, sino yung nagsabi? Sino yung sabi na nag-blurred?
Tapos nag-focus.
Tapos nag-ano, Nish?
Tapos nag-blurred ang thumb, tapos nag-focus siya sa... Nag-focus siya sa image sa isa ko mata.
Okay.
Nag-focus siya sa... Sa left side.
Okay, sige. So, thank you so much. Congratulations for that very simple activity. At least, parang we can imagine how the astronomers uses those strategies in observing, no? Okay, our stars. Now, so we have here also what we call the stereo vision. Can you see my PowerPoint? Ayan na. So what is a stereo vision? You use parallax constantly to estimate distances. So we can use parallax again constantly, yes, to use estimate distances. So what you will do is just close your eyes, have a neighbor dangle a pen in front of you, then open just one eye. So without moving your head, bring your hand in from the side and try to touch the pencil with just the tip of another pen. So actually, anong nangyari is that your brain processes the information from each eye and compares the angles to allow you to judge distances. Okay, another question. Sige nga, who can answer? Why do stars twinkle? Naniniwala ba kayo twinkle twinkle ang mga stars? Yung kinakanta natin sa mga children na twinkle twinkle little star. Yes, Miss Nish, you are raising your hand. What is your idea? Nish or David Daniel?
Kay ano sir, kay nag-fusion 'di ba ang hydrogen kag helium. So sa ano sa use ng gravity daw mag turn siya sa a cloud of dust, tapos after sina ng ang light niya sir do nagakusog like the blue siya sir amo tapos ga twinkle twinkle siya sa sky.
Wow, at least you have now the idea. How about you, Daniel? David Daniel. Next is Joshua. Do you believe that stars twinkle?
Sir, so ako sir, my is different fish. Pwede lang po ba yun, sir?
Okay, go. Why?
For me, what who says the stars to twinkle, twinkle? Actually, they don't twinkle. Much more on naka-base sila. Sabi nga ni Nish kanina na for them to cause a light is kailangan muna mag-fusion ng hydrogen saka ng helium and magsisend sila ng solar flare. So now, it always occur, but sometimes parang meron tinatawag na time gap. And from those time gap, especially if you observe those stars from millions of light years away, of course, there will be tinatawag natin na parang nakundir sila, nagbalik ulit, nakundir sila. So they look like they twinkle, but actually they just, you know, parang nakulangan lang ng energy ng pag-explode nila, sir.
Okay, sige. Very good. At least you are sharing with your idea. How about, sino pa yung mga nag-raise ng hand? Gino? Hazel? Sharing Joy Tunan? Nag-raise ka ng hands? Joshua? Holmina? Yes? Any idea? Nag-raise ka ng hand. Renaline, hindi alam.
My idea, sir, is Star
Dawn. Yes, Hazel.
Ako, sir.
Yes. Yeah. Si Hazel muna, followed by Rena.
Okay, sir. Sir, my thoughts about Twinkle, Twinkle, sir. Ang star is, wala siya ka-twinkle. Kay tungod sang, ano, nagatabo siya tungod. Ayan. Nang nagatwinkle, twinkle siya tungod kay gatabo nga ang dust sa aton ng atmosphere.
Sige, singgit ano yung dito.
Tama, sir.
Okay, sige. How about you, Rena?
As light from a star, sir, races through our atmosphere, it bounces and bumps different layers and lean the light before you see it. So, amo yung dahilan nga naga, kung tuloko ng star, sir, ang appearance yung naga twinkle, twinkle.
Okay.
Kasi since na ang hot and cold layers of air.
Yes.
It's moving. Tapos naga-bend ang light. Amo to siya naga
Okay, it seems that Rena already researched it in the Google, no? Parang meron siyang bright idea. Okay, sige, naka-research yun siya. So, actually, the scientific name for the twinkling of star is what we call the stellar scintillation. Pinasosyal ha. Actually, yung other term for English, sabi natin they are just twinkling, but actually, the correct word is that astronomical scintillation or a stellar scintillation. Diba social, no? Magsabi ka, hindi man yan ga-twinkle, it's just a stellar scintillation. So, stars, except for the sun, they appear as tiny dots in the sky. Okay. So, as their light travels through the many layers of the Earth's atmosphere, the light of the star is bent. Wow, galing-galing talaga ni Rena. Sabi ko nga, naka-research. No, actually, yung light nila through, sabi ko nina, as the light travels, so they bent, and the light of the star is bent, or what we call refracted, so many times and in random directions. Imagine nyo kasi yung atmosphere natin, there are layers. So we have troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, diba? Thermosphere. So the light from the star, actually, before ma-reach nya dito sa Earth, it bended. No, kaya dito, kung nasa Earth tayo, we can see na, ay, para siyang nag-twinkling, twinkle, but actually, lights are just bending, no? So, this random refraction results in the star winking out, or it looks as though the star moves a bit, and our eye interpret this as twinkling, okay? Yun lang pala, nag-bound siya with a different atmosphere. So, the Earth atmosphere actually with moving pockets of cold and air. So, tingnan nyo dito in the picture. For example, this is the light rays. Ayan, nag-bend siya, nag-refract hanggang makarating sa Earth. So, we think that they are moving, no? Pero actually, that's what we call a stellar. More scientific way of expressing that is a stellar scintillation. Meaning, lights are bending. So, okay na? So, among all answers, parang si Rena talaga ang nakakuha ng tumpak na sagot, no? With all the bending. Kaya, pabor din sa kanya kasi may time talaga siya to research. Okay, now, so what are the characteristics of stars? Kunti na lang. Of course, in the size, anywhere from 20 kilometers to 1 trillion kilometers in diameter. So, masyadong malayo, di ba? Or yung size nila, sobrang laki. Imagine niyo gano'ng kalaki ang 20 kilometers to 1 trillion kilometers in diameter. Malaki? Malapad? 20 kilometers? Malapad ba? Yes.
Malaki tira.
Oh, sobrang lapad ng mga stars. Imagine, magbaktas ka ganis ang 1 kilometer, kapoy-kapoy. How much more ang 20 kilometers? I don't know from Marbel to Jensen, ilang kilometers yan? Ilan ba? Did you measure? How many? How long? Sige, i-google nyo nga. How many kilometers from Marbel to Jensen? Kung makaabot siya ng 20. Or more than.
116, sir.
Okay, so medyo... So meaning, kung 116 siya, sige, mga Marbel to Tupi, mga 20 kilometers.
Sir, 154.
Oh, 154. Pero
sa akin, sir, 58.6 kilometers.
Ang Marbel to Jensen? Okay.
Sige. Yes, sir. Dumagdag pa si Inish. 0.6, tama, sir. 58.6 kilometers ang Jensen to Coronadan.
Okay, sige, sige. Now, let's continue with the mass.
Ah, in the diameter.
Oh, okay. Mass is, it depends on the amount of matter, di ba? Doon sa mga stars. And the colors of the stars are red, we have blue, white, orange, or yellow. And their composition is contained different elements determined using spectra. So, paano pa natin malalaman yung composition ng isang star? We will use a spectra. So here is the characteristics of stars. Okay. So for temperature, actually blue is the hottest, red is the coolest, and yellow, our sun, is nasa middle part lang siya, almost 5,500 degree Celsius. Also in luminosity, the actual brightness of the star, meaning it depends on size and temperature. So, doon nakadepende ang kanyang luminosity o yung brightness ng isang between. Depende sa kanyang laki at temperature. So, apparent magnitude naman, meaning these are the measure of how bright a star appears to be on Earth. So, there are the lower the number, higher the brightness. So, does not measure how bright a star actually is. And another one is absolute magnitude naman, meaning a measure of how bright a star would be if all stars were at the same distance or 10 parsecs from Earth. Okay, so let's study this one, the magnitude. So, tingnan nyo, saan ba yung pinaka-brighter? Okay, so our sun, nandito siya, almost negative 26.5, okay? And for the dimmer, nandito na naman sila. So, we cannot see actually the dimmer that positive 6 with the naked eye. So, actually, there are some stars that we cannot see them. No? Kapag nasa positive 6 pataas. So, si Sun, nakikita talaga natin kasi sobrang liwanag niya nasa negative 26.5. So, maliwanag na maliwanag. Another thing is si Sirius. Actually, Sirius is the brightest in the sky from Earth. Nasa negative 2. And si Polaris naman, or the Northern Star, nandito siya banda sa mga positive 3. Okay, so now let's discuss apparent magnitude versus luminosity. So for example, we have two stars. Star 1 has high luminosity, far from Earth, while star 2 is low luminosity, but close to Earth or close to Earth. So meaning, star 1 actually lower apparent magnitude, while for star 2, there are higher apparent magnitude. So meaning, low, hindi natin siya mas nakikita si star 2, kahit sabihin natin they are closest to Earth since they have low luminosity but higher apparent magnitude. Another thing, we have your Hertzsprung-Russell diagram. Ito, ginamitan talaga ni Hertzsprung-Russell para madali maintindihan, a relationship between the absolute magnitude or what we call the luminosity and the temperature of stars. Kasi doon man nakasalalay, di ba? Sabi dito, nakasalalay yung ano daw ni star, ang kanyang luminosity depends on the size and temperature. So sabi dito ni Hertzsprung-Russell, A spectral class designates the color of stars. So it depends on temperature from hottest to the coolest. Ayan, pinakita niya talaga dito, the hottest to the coolest. And from blue to white to yellow to orange or to red. So imagine, nandito na side is represents the luminosity while here are the absolute magnitude. So for example, titingnan nyo, ayan, yung mga blue color natin, ayan po, ayan. So we have also the blue giants, and then the green, we have the red super giants, red giants. So in terms of brightness, color blue is very bright, no? Okay, ayan. But in terms of magnitude, the temperature, red supergiants are very hot. So supergiants, actually, those are the largest of all stars and very luminous. Kaya ganito, for example, when we are here on Earth, actually, most of the stars we see above are the supergiants. Red giants naman are cooler, large, and also very luminous din. So meaning second sila with supergiants. Dwarf stars, they are less luminous, red, orange, or yellow. While a white dwarf, very faint, small, and dense. So what are the variable stars? So, it vary in brightness over regular periods or cycles. So, ayan, tingnan natin. So, there are two types. We have here the pulsating and expand. So, a pulsating meaning change in brightness as they contract, they become brighter. While expanding, kung pa-expand naman siya, ayan po, so it becomes dimmer. No? Kung lumalaki siya, sipid, yellow, or supergiant. Another thing, aside from pulsating, we have here non-pulsating naman. Yung merong tinatawag ng mga eclipsing binary. The two stars of an equal brightness that revolve around each other brightness depends on which one is in front of the other. Oh, for example, here, no? So we have here the two stars of an equal brightness. So sometimes they revolve around each other brightness. So it depends on which is in front of the other. So nadadala, no? Halimbawa kung medyo dimmer yung front niya, so hindi masyado siya nakikita. Pero kung mas bright yung sa front, okay, go. So pulsars, what are pulsars? Pulsars are stars that releases light and radio waves in pulses, maybe in neutron star formed in a supernova, and it looks like it pulses because it is rotating like a searchlight. Oh, yan ang mukha ng ating mga pulsars. They are stars that releases light and radio waves in pulses. Okay, maybe ito yung sa mga neutron star, diba? Formed in a supernova. Kaya kung nag-supernova ng isang star, so magiging neutron star siya. So yan. Okay, and the last one, the life cycle of a star. So I hope you will going to familiarize this one from, it's all started with stellar nebula, no? So pwede siya actually ang isang star mag-average star or pwede din siya as massive star. Now, doon muna tayo sa average star. When it is average star, it become the red giant. And later on, magiging, kung maubos ng kanyang kinang, magiging planetary nebula and turns into white dwarf. While, when it is a massive star, it will become a red supergiant, okay? And mag-explode siya, or tinatawag natin supernova, or pwede siya maging after the explosion, or after supernova, pwede siyang black hole or neutron star. Okay? So, any questions? And congratulations, natapos na natin ang ating prelim lesson. Any question?